do for his draft stock?
Oh man, it'll put a rocket to it if he continues to play in this tournament like that. The scouts are going to get more and more interested. Also, a little more jittery as they might have had a player slotted in a certain area of the draft. He plays like that, he's going to jump a couple of spots in the draft for sure. This is really an important start to the tournament for him.
Yeah, and this is where kind of all of a sudden the stocks kind of rise and fall here, right? Hi, everybody. Welcome back to EA Sports. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Fraser, we'll send it down to you at ice level. How do you see this tail of the tape breaking down?
You got a couple of teams that don't have much threat between the two of them, but they both can score in the power play. If you get yourself into trouble by taking an unnecessary penalty, that might very easily be the difference in this game.
Both teams lined up in the middle. We are ready to get things underway. Well, the hype for this one has been off the hook. Puck is dropped. Let's see if this one actually lives up to it. Moves it to foot. Kelowna's moving it along the wing. From one point man to another. And he comes up with it. St. John's gained possession along the boards. Kidd's got it on the offensive end. Couldn't connect, although not exactly an ideal pass to begin with. St. John's got the puck in their own end. Receives the pass. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. That pass doesn't go. Puck picked up by Foot. And they send it right back to him. Kelowna's on the attack. From the slot, wrist shot. Oh, just wide of the net.
It doesn't matter how close it is. If it's not on the net, it can't go in.
And he takes a shot, and he makes the save. And there's the whistle on the heels of that save and the puck going out of play. Lots of time left in this period. We're still scoreless. Kelowna's got it in the defensive zone. Through center along the wing. Kelowna's got the puck against the half wall. Sends the pass over. Here's a short pass to Kidd. Grabs the puck and looks to make something happen. Made the save on the play. Makes the save as he gets a piece of it with the glove. And they can't connect. And the puck stopper jumps on top of it to get a stoppage in play. Still lots of time left in the period. Still scoreless in this one. St. John's got it, and they're on the attack. Past the midway mark of the frame, James and Ray with you tonight. We've still got zeros on the board. One's won the draw deep in the defensive zone, trying to clear the puck. Whistle blown as a few players go ducking for cover on the bench. Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. St. John's won the faceoff. Takes a shot, gets in front of it. Kelowna's penalty killers get a hold of it. The man advantage is over. The Rockets take it across the line. The Sea Dogs gain control of the puck against the wall. Play whistled dead because of an offside.
Now we'll get another look at this. That's a good shot, but the goalie's getting the blocker up to make the save.
The Sea Dogs win possession here in the open ice. Quick feed to Reynolds. The Sea Dogs are on the attack. Hammers it on net, and he stands tall in goal. Kids won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. He scores! The Sea Dogs finally get a goal, and it couldn't come at better timing, Razor.
There's been no room on the ice, and now maybe this will crack this thing open a little bit.
Faceoff here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. Puts it in deep. His reflexes on display tonight.
15 minutes, 4 seconds.
The Rockets take it across the blue line. Kelowna's got the puck along the wall. Coughs it up on the play. Quick pass to Kidd. Enters the offensive zone from the left.
Reynolds shows good hands collecting the pass. He's our
scores! Oh, that was a beauty!
Bang, bang, two goals in right around a minute 40.
Conversely, deflating for the other team.
Man, that is a kick in the shins right there. They just couldn't stop the bleeding. Man, the goalie's gonna look at his teammates and say, is anybody gonna cover the high slot? He was so open, he was able to hammer home the one-timer.
Here in the late goings of the period, St. John's got a two-goal lead. They'd love to build on it. From the neutral zone now. St. John's got a hold of the puck. And now it's over to Kidd. From center, they get into the attacking area. Puts it up front, and just out of arm's reach on the play. And he denied that opportunity. The Sea Dogs have controlled this game here in the first period. More shots, more goals. Kidd's won the draw. Here's a shot, and that one's blocked. The Rockets are in transition. Along the half wall with the puck. St. John's got a hold of it along the wall and tries to make a diagonal pass to Kidd. Less than a minute to go here in the opening frame. Moves the puck along the half wall. Puts it on net with the stop. Puck possession so critical. Another faceoff coming up here. And the opening faceoff here in period number two is about set. Kidd's won the draw. There's the whistle from the linesman calling it offside. Oh, and we got a fight.
It doesn't even have to be a hard shot. It can be a muffin, but everybody is going to defend the goalie when you shoot the puck that late after a whistle.
Wow, and it's time for referee Gilles Levesque to step on in here, right?
This is clearly over, James. Well, they were going at it pretty good there. The home side's going to get a lot of energy out of that decision. This has been a pretty good run for them right now. They've piled some goals up quickly, but the coach is reminding them this isn't over yet. He goes right down to his youngest player and gives him a little prod not to take a nap. There's still time left in this game.
That's why he's the best in the business, Mr. Ray Ferraro. Past the midway mark in this period. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. The Sea Dogs get a hold of the puck off the draw. Nice feed at center, moves up ahead now. Takes a shot. He scores! They take the lead!
Well, it looked like this game was going to be even for the longest time because nobody seemed to have the upper hand.
The Sea Dogs' hard work finally pays off with a one-goal lead in the second.
That was a lot of effort just to get to the lead. Now you want to stay aggressive so you don't give it back.
And he slides it quickly to Foot. Makes the save.
Jones makes the save and gets the puck into the corner very efficiently.
Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. A chance from the slot. Stopped by the goaltender.
Oh, he reads the play really well to get out and aggressive to make that save.
St. John's lead here in the second period, a direct result of being the more aggressive team offensively. Puck has dropped and we are back underway. St. John's got it in their own zone. From the right wing, he moves it to the middle. And that goes wide.
Tough to generate a rebound even when the puck...
He scores! They make it another!
They don't slow down. You get one, you get two. A quick flick of the wrist, and that snapshot beats the goaltender. He's in the low slot. He doesn't have much time to think about it. It's pretty rare when you play a game, and in the middle of the game, the coach gives you a pat and says you're doing a great job. But the rookie has been excellent tonight. James, he got an assignment early. We heard him talking to the coach about it, and he's delivered.
He's been absolutely excellent. We call his name a bunch tonight. St. John's got an insurance marker here. They now lead by two in the second.
Don't back off, though. Keep pushing ahead. Play the game in the offensive half of the ice.
Gains the zone through center. 14 minutes, 9 seconds. Here he is in front, and they can't convert on the play. Moves it quickly over to Kidd and makes the save. Juan's lugging the puck. Offside the call, and we'll have a face-off just outside the blue line.
The rookie's been a big part of this dominating portion of the game. They've been all over the opposition, and the coach is reminding them, don't take a step back. Keep pushing the pace.
They've been like a pack of Wolverines out there on the ice to this point. Well past the midway mark of this period, St. John's been the better team here over the last few minutes, increasing their lead to two. Offside is the call, that we'll have a face-off just outside the offensive zone. The Sea Dogs are checking all the boxes tonight. More shots, more goals, and they lead in the second. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. And now he angles it across to Kidd. Couldn't catch up to that pass. The Sea Dogs get a hold of the puck along the boards. Chance right in front. Scores! They are on fire!
Yeah, and it's all different sources, too. Score a goal, make a change, get another one. Nothing seems to slow them down. He's probably got about 2 seconds from the time that puck's delivered to find it. He can't see it, so he drops into the butterfly and hopes it hits him.
St. John's offensive onslaught continues late in this second period.
Dominant performance from early in the first period. They absolutely deserve to be where they're at.
The Sea Dogs are on cruise control here in the second. They have absolutely dominated. Puck is dropped and play resumes. Moved up ahead after a nice pass from the right wing. There's the whistle. Offside is the call, stopping the play. St. John's generated a lot of quality scoring chances, which is why they lead here late in the second. Kidd's one possession. It go. He scores! How's that to close things out?
Wow, what a great time for a goal. I mean, you're happy when you score any time, but so late in the period, now you can carry momentum over the intermission. This is the default move for the goaltender here. It's like every shot, he drops into the butterfly. He gets beaten clean here.
Rockets are going to make a change in goal.
He can't get over to the bench quick enough. Now he can get rid of that mask, throw in a ball hat, wrap a towel around his neck, and try and relax. This has been a rotten night for him.
St. John's been in simple attack mode all night long. Would you not agree?
Yes, and the opponent has no answer. It's like they can't get up to speed to take any of the pace away.
There's the horn ending period number two. I'm not sure they wanted it to end.
With hot food and ice cold beverages, now's your chance to join us at one of our many concession stands located throughout the stadium.
Teams are lined up and they are ready to get this third period underway. 20 minutes to go here in regulation of what has been a very one-sided affair. There's the whistle, penalty coming up. Kidd's getting called for 2 minutes here by the officials.
Fishing around for the puck, he gets a stick into the player's feet, and this becomes an easy call.
Our first look tonight at their power play unit.
If you can find a way to get a power play goal here, you can change the momentum of this game. They haven't got one yet tonight. And you find...
He scores! What a goal! St. John's all too aware there's no mercy rule in hockey. They continue to apply the pressure.
No, they're laying a beating on these guys now. It may be time to lay back just a bit.
The Rockets carry it along the wall. Here's a shot denied by the goaltender.
Good save. Positional save through traffic.
Takes the pass. The Sea Dogs will play it in their own end. Regains control here in the neutral zone.
Reynolds receives the puck now.
And that's the hat trick. Listen to this place.
And here come the hats. I love this tradition, although I will tell you, they collect the hats up. They used to give them to us, and you're like, what am I going to do? I'm not wearing somebody else's hat. Actually, James, it's amazing to me how many times an odd man rush gets screwed up. They deliver this one perfectly, and they put one on the board.
The Sea Dogs continue to rack up the goals here in this third period.
They can do no wrong. It doesn't seem to matter who's on the ice. They're the better team.
The Rockets win it. Puck picked up in the open ice. Pokes it away here in the neutral zone. Takes it to the net. Stopped by the goaltender.
I like the goalie's positioning here. He was aggressive enough to make a save on a dangerous chance. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
The official signaling for a penalty as play is called. Kidd's called for tripping. He's off to the box.
I guess it's a little bit of bad luck, James. I mean, he's reaching for the puck. He's in position to try and keep the play moving, but he trips him up.
The Rockets send their man advantage unit out once more.
2 minutes for tripping. Time of the penalty, 5 minutes, 8 seconds.
The Sea Dogs are back to even strength as the PK unit comes up large.
Sometimes you go on the ice with the best of intentions and it goes all wrong right away. That's how I'd characterize that power play.
And that's blocked. Handles the puck. Ahead of steam now towards the front. And that one's stopped. The Sea Dogs have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Nice pass.
Kid's night's been about perfect. He's got 3 goals already. He's looking for another one.
And that's just out of reach. Now into the offensive zone from the right side. Shot in front. Stopped by the goaltender. Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. Here's an odd man rush. Unleashes a cannon. Denies him. He got all of it. Comrie's got it in the defensive end. And the officials stop the play as the puck hits off the ice.
Pretty good work on the two-on-one. The defenseman gives the goalie the shooter, and he makes a save.
St. John's laying a pounding on the opposition tonight, generating numerous scoring chances and converting on what feels like almost all of them. The Sea Dogs play it along the boards. Cuts to the paint. He scores! And this place is going bananas. They know what the moment's all about.
Well, I guess we know who the first star's probably going to be. That's 3-4 tonight. Goalie just can't keep up with this. He's close to the net, but he's still able to have enough room to beat the goaltender.
St. John's having a lot of fun out there tonight, but Ray, I can imagine it's a different story on the other side of the bench.
Yeah, half the guys out here are having fun. The other half, this game can't end quick enough.
Moves the puck. Moves it to Kidd. He scores! That's how you do it! Leadership to a T! The captain capitalizes!
This is a really good place to get lost on the ice. The defensemen are down low defending. The forwards are worried about the point. If you can find this high slot play, you often are going to get a one-timer.
St. John's taking a playbook out of the Ray Ferraro School of Hockey here. Just be aggressive, goal
when
after
you,
goal.
Man, when you score, go get another one. You've got the other team down, go get more. Because you make yourself feel better, you build your own.
He scores! And that's the hat trick! And here comes the rain!
The hats start piling onto the ice. The celebration shows it's just not a normal goal. The hat trick's always special. That's a scorer's goal right there. That puck is on and off his stick in a hurry. He's so tight to the net, he has to get rid of it before the goalie can readjust.
The Sea Dogs are on absolute cruise control here in the third.
Well, they've built such a large margin, you can use your whole bench and coast it in.
The Rockets win the draw here in the neutral zone.
His third of the game.
From his own end, he picks up the puck.
Assisted and by number 33. And by number
skates to the crease. Pokes it away in his own end. Slides the puck into the offensive zone. And he totally whiffs on that one. Up along the wing. And a poke check knocks the puck away. Maintains possession. And makes a save.
Jones has had plenty of support offensive.
Here he is, all alone. Oh, what a stop. There it is. It's in.
I don't think it's going to matter, Jason. I get a look at this immediately. I think no goal. This was waved off hard immediately. The Rockets are not happy campers here. They think this is goalie interference, and they want this reviewed right away.
Ray, I don't think they're going to get the review and not have to worry about it. This is being waved off by referee Gilles Levesque here completely. Play set to resume, and you can see they're still frustrated by that non-goal call. This neutral zone faceoff set to go, and we are back underway. There's an offside stopping the clock late in this one. St. John's offense has not been a problem tonight. They put a lot of shots on net and lead it big time late in this third period. Kids won the draw here in the open ice. The Sea Dogs move the puck in the defensive zone. Slides it on over to Kidd. And the final seconds ticking away here in regulation. Puts one on net and another stop.
Kidd's changed his focus here, James. It looks like he's finished fighting and now he's going to play the game.
Takes the feed at the point. Oh, you'll win respect for your teammates doing that. What a block. They've got the defense outnumbered. Slides it across. Can't connect. The Rockets gain possession along the wall. Carries it in. Fires one on goal. Big time stop there. The Sea Dogs gain possession in their own end. Working the puck deep inside their own end. All alone. Denies him on the breakaway.
Really good speed to get out in front. Dust the pack. Now it's him and the goalie. But the goalie's better. He makes the stop.
Comes up with the stop. And that'll do it for ringside. just made the ice look tilted out there this evening, Ray.
Real good forecheck. Their defense kept a real tight gap, so they were able to turn the puck back over in the offensive zone. Man, they owned this game start to finish.